All right, it is now 8:16 on a Wednesday morning. It's raining. Let's continue. All right, pull back seat out. I would think that'd be pretty obvious. I'm doing the rear ones on these is both easier and more difficult at the same time. I'll explain when we get there. Let's go ahead and get the old seat belt out of the way. This 17 millimeter fits this bolt up here. You don't have to put a wrench on the nut. It's held in inside this mount. Just kind of push it through and pull it out. And be careful with your battery right here, especially if you leave it connected like I have or whatever, but you don't want any of these metal parts arcing across the terminals or going from positive to ground. You know the drill. Right, now this little piece at first would appear to be extremely difficult to get out. On this side, what looks like an Allen bolt is not. It's actually almost like a wheel stud. It's through a piece of metal, and you're not turning that with any sort of Allen wrench, so ignore that. The only way you can get this off is by taking the nut off this back side here, which, as you can tell, is way up inside of here. There's a little bit of a cavity here, but it ain't enough to get a ratchet or even a wrench on. At first, I thought I was going to have to just remove the entire side of the razor to get that off, but I found an easier way. This is my trusty little old, I don't know how old this thing is, pull handle. It's not all that huge as far as pull handles go, but it has the advantage of having a rotating head. And if you'll notice, it will go past 90 degrees. It will go on closer to maybe 110. And that is exactly what we need to get that loose without having to take the machine apart. All right, I got a 3/4 socket here. It'll fit that bolt. I'm sure there's a metric size it will too, but I already had this one handy. And I can get this down in that cavity and attach it to that nut. And as you can see, with this being able to go past 90 degrees, it just fits right in there. All I have to do is about 67 turns, quarter turns with this pull handle, and it's loose. Even longer if the socket doesn't stay connected. So we'll see in about 30 minutes. I'll reach down here, taking that rest of the way off. All right, there's the ratchet out. Let's get the rest of the factory seat belt out, and the very last piece of factory seat belt in here. A little, I usually have a name for that, but I'm not gonna say it on the video here, but you may can guess. So, yeah, push the boots down inside. And you got two push pins here, T40 here on both sides, and then a push pin here on each side. And up here, if you're in that four seater, this isn't already out, but I'm just gonna kind of raise up on it a little bit. Just kind of get this loose and set it off to the side. Now, if you're taking it all the way out, be mindful that this is on the four seater, this is a 12 volt outlet here. You'll want to connect these wires loose before you snatch on it too hard and mess up these connectors. All right, so now we want to go ahead and remove this bolt. I think this is the, is this the 16-19 combo or the, yeah, it's something. We'll see. All right, so yeah, you got a 16 millimeter socket here with a 19. Wow, those are tight. 19 millimeter wrench. I don't want to push down on that too hard. I'm going to crack my knuckles against that bar. Pull over here so I can pull on it. push on it. Oh, it's like the only tight one out of the bunch. It's probably the very first one. And then he kind of went downhill from there. Notice how that is trying to gravitate toward the battery. This is mostly plastic, rubber, and all the way to here, but still not comfortable with it touching it. Now for the shoulder strap connection back here, if you're not using snorkels, you have some options. And the best option, easiest option, will be to buy one of the harness bars that connects from here, goes across, and it ties to the cage on the other side. If you're using a factory cage, you have an aftermarket cage, you've already got a place to hook your harnesses, I'm sure. Now you can just simply connect them to this bar, but the problem with that is this bar is higher than the pass-throughs in the seats. So your harnesses will come up, go through the pass-through, and then come up again. That's not going to give you a very good position for the harnesses themselves. Having them wrap around and come straight down is not ideal, but it is better than having them mounted above the pass-throughs. Ideally, they're supposed to be backwards at, I don't know, like a 20 degree angle from the seat or something like that. That's what they recommend, but options are limited in these vehicles, especially the four-seater. Now there is, I think UTV Inc. actually has a bar that will mount, that mounts to these, that will go around behind the seat and keep the angle at the right angle. There's a trick to that. Let me explain real quick. If you were to attach your harnesses to that bar, because of this Y shape, this would be completely jammed up against the center here, because you wouldn't have enough room to buckle all this stuff together around that bar that's literally going to be sitting right here behind the seat. So what you'd end up doing is using that bar as a guide, go around that bar and then come down to this bar and connect everything up. To me, that little bit right there, just not worth it. So on the back one, instead of doing it the way I'm going to show you how to do it, if you want to do it that way, or if you have snorkels, or you just simply don't want to buy a $140 bar, which is a little high, everybody agrees with that, except the people that sell it. But Dragonfire sells a bar that goes across here for two seat risers and the back of the four seat riser. It clamps here, it follows this, it goes down, goes up on the other side, and connects over there. The problem is, it runs like literally right here, so my snorkels could not be a thing. I'd have to abandon that, which is not happening, so this is the reason I came up with an alternative. But there again, where the pass-throughs are in the seat, this bar is going to be so close to them, you're not actually going to be able to connect the harnesses, these style harnesses, probably any of the Y style harnesses, to that bar. You're going to have to come through the seat, under the bar, and then come up to this bar in order to make your connection. So, I will show you what I did. To get to the fun part, we have to remove this cover panel. There's four 240 torque screws along here, and then one right here that goes into the air box to kind of keep it steady. On this side, got four more here, cross. You gotta remove your engine cover. This can be done even with these clamps and these snorkel tubes on here. This can still come off. It's not easy, but it can be done. So what we're gonna do is lift it up and then rotate it like this and get it out, slide it off the side, and remove it. Now I've already done the trouble of figuring out where the cutout needs to go, so I can simply just show you on this side where to cut it, how to measure it, and take all the guesswork out of it for you. Now we have to cut a notch in this panel for the belt to pass through and connect down to the frame. Now I'll be the first to admit, this is not the most beautiful solution here. Fortunately, it is completely covered by the seat. The only time you'll see this is when the seats are out. These little soft ridges I got here, that's actually a vent tube that I cut and split and put over the top and bottom, but it wasn't completely necessary. The belt doesn't even touch the sides because I managed to get this like just right. I'm actually considering getting some edging material and wrapping it all the way around this just to kind of clean that up. So in order to cut this, the first corner right here is this corner right there. Right here on this corner is where we're going to start. We're going to draw a line straight down from that, and then we're going to measure over 3 inches, and that's going to be the other edge of it. It's 3 inches. The belts are 2, the buckle is 2.5. 3 gives it plenty of room on both sides, even lets it have a little wiggle room without touching anything. And we're going to cut it right across this top bend. And we're going to measure over 3.5 inches from the center of this hole. So 3.5 inches, we'll just kind of mark that. Now, since this is 3 inches across, we're just going to go 1.5 inches to each side and make a mark. Using this pencil, it writes on this stuff and it washes off pretty easy, so you don't have to worry about that being permanent. It's kind of shadowy. I'm going to see if I can turn it toward the light a little bit. But now I've got my starting mark, and then my mark 3 inches over, and then my bottom mark, and then 1.5 inches to either side of it, which gives me a total of 3 inches. So now we line these up and draw a line. And then line these two marks up, do the same thing. I'm just gonna kinda color that in, make it easier to see. And hook your tape measure right over here, right at the bottom of that little indention. And then on this side, kind of pull it tight and get it in the same place. That way, you have a nice straight line all the way across. You see how that lines up on this one? So, where this comes down, it notches in, it goes straight down. Put it right at the bottom of that notch on both sides. You get it there. Just draw a line, even with the tape, across here. That'll be the bottom of the cutout, which hopefully will be pretty obvious. If you didn't understand that part, you may just want to go ahead and stop now. Now just use your preferred method of cutting these out. I use a Dremel tool with whatever this thing is. It's like it's almost like a router bit, but it cuts this plastic really well. I'm just going to trim the hole out with this, and I'll go back with this little sanding wheel and kind of smooth it off. Alright, let's see. It is loose. I'm going to swap my little sander wheel here and clean that hole up. Alright, let's get this over by the machine, and then we'll move to the next part of the shoulder straps, which is the rest of the hard part. To get ready for this next part, draw a line up here 3.5 inches over from the center of this hole. I'm gonna put it right about here. Let me briefly describe what's going on here. This is the connection buckle, turnbuckle, whatever you call this thing, for the shoulder strap. Now, as I explained, I can't put it up here because of the angle. I can't buy the bar and attach it to it because I have snorkels. So therefore, it needs to go down, and it needs to connect to the frame metal somewhere. And this is it. This is the only metal bar in this entire vicinity. Can't do it down here because the way the seat angles back, you will be past the 90 degree turn of the belts. If there was a reason for them to really hold all this together, in say the event of an accident, they're not actually going to begin pulling until the seat gets past that 90 degrees. Anything back from that, the belts are actually going to go slack as you come forward. So you don't want your mounting point to be over 90 degrees down at the very, very least. The less you can get from 90, the better, but you definitely don't want to go over. 90 is the best I can do in my setup. So can't put it down here. Now you think, okay, we'll just bolt that right through there and tie to it, it'll be outside of the panel easy. Well, again, you're past the 90 degree point here. So okay, so let's drill a hole here and put it like that. Yeah, well, that'll work, but look how much bolt you got sticking out. You'll have the panel here with your screws in it, and then the end of the bolt sticking straight out of the edge here, which look really stupid. Not that anybody's going to see it, but still, I don't want that. So, all right, well, let's just cut that bolt off. Well, this is a grade 8 bolt. I mean, you could probably torch it off, but you're not cutting it off. Not with anything I have on hand, at any rate. So, what to do? Well, we have to replace the bolt. All right, we're going to replace the bolt. So, it still has to go in this direction. The reason being is when you replace the bolt, you're going to lose this shoulder unless you special order one with this flanged head that has the shoulder. That's the right size. That's the right length. A little too much to contend with, to be honest. And this needs to be on the inside in order to get past that 90 degrees. This opens it up closer to, say, 80, which is a little more like what I would like. So we're going to have to replace the bolt. As you can see on this side, my solution. I took a long bit and drilled me a pilot hole through both pieces of plastic and the metal bar. And then I took a hole saw and opened up the plastic so that the bolts would be in direct contact with the metal and not sandwiching the plastic, which is not going to be as secure of a connection. Did that on both sides. And then I drilled the hole through the metal to open it up for the bolt. And what I've got here is some of the hardware from the original and some new. This is a 7/16 grade 8 2.5-inch bolt. And then it goes to a grade 8 flat washer and then through the metal bar. And then the spacer off the original hardware right here to help space this back away as far back as I could comfortably get it without putting too much torque on the bolt itself in the event that this gets heavily pulled on, we'll say. So the spacer, and then one of the nuts that came from the original one is here. And then I did a flat washer, lock washer, and then a new nut that I got with the bolt. Now this doesn't move, but then again, it doesn't need to because it is always just going to come straight up and come straight through the seats. It's never going to be pulled in another direction. So it is okay for this one to be rigid, but you do want it straight. You don't want it, when you get it tightened, to be angled one way or the other. Get it straight across, even with this bar, and then we'll tighten that up. So with knowing what's gonna happen, we'll go through it and I'll kind of explain as I go. Something to keep in mind here when you're drilling through all this stuff, you do not want to go into that. That is a rubber tube right there. That is your engine intake on the clean side of the filter. So you go through that and put even a pinhole in it, you're going to start sucking dust up in your engine. So I'm going to protect it with that little wooden block here while I'm working with power tools. I'm going to line up with my pencil mark I made there. You don't want to go all the way down here. You want to be more toward the center of this bar, but slightly to the top of it if possible. So just a little above the halfway point on that plastic lip here. And we'll get through the plastic. You also do not want to go at a downward angle. Try to keep your drill pretty level so that as you come through, you're not causing yourself some extra trouble on the other side. Alright, through the first side. Now again, make sure you're just good and level here. Then I'm going to push through. Right through the plastic, right into my wooden block. Alrighty, rain's back. Doing pretty good now. Alright, next step. Go ahead, now that we got our pilot hole done, go ahead and remove this T40 bolt right here. We're going to have to pry this up and drill it out, and I'll show you what I mean in a second. Now what I've got is a 1-inch hole saw. This is what I'm going to use to open up the plastic here large enough for the bolt to be able to pass through and be in direct contact with the metal. Well, since all the bolts are out of this, I'm going to just pry it away a little bit. And then I'll use my hole saw to trim it out after I put it in high gear. All right, now I got a nice cutout right there for my bolt. Now we have to do the same thing to the other side, but we can't do it from the other side because of this big ridge right here. You won't never get a drill and a hole saw down in there, so we gotta do it from here. So we're gonna have to pry up on this panel to make enough room to reach under there. All right, Mr. Light, I need you to just stay right there, please. To get this drill up in here, oh my goodness, and drill that out. This one's gonna be a little harder to start because you're working from the inside of an angle, which always makes it more difficult. I'm not sure how long this video is going to be. I'm right now at 2 hours of just raw footage, and that's not including the time I stop when I'm getting things ready. Oh well, all my videos are long. You guys are used to that by now, I'm sure. All right, now part two of this is you have to use this to chew away the plastic down here to give your enough room to get the flat washer and the bottom of the bracket and all that stuff up in here and your socket to or wrench or whatever to attach to it. There's not enough room from this plastic lip to here for all that to fit, so we have to take this out. The easiest way to do it is just use this hole saw and just continue to cut your way through. Now I do not want to hit this, so I'm going to get something thinner to put between there. I found this little piece of plastic. This is actually a leftover piece of Donnie's roof on his RZR. That's a good story. You have to ask him about that when you see him. All right, I'm gonna just set that right in there. Pry this up a little bit more, give me some room. Let the hole guide the bit. I'm gonna, hopefully you can see it, and I'm gonna chew right on through. And cut that out. Give me a nice, even like rounded off notch for everything to fit in. And tube is safe. At this point, I'm gonna go ahead and put this Torx bolt back in. That'll help keep this thing down and out of your way while you're working around it. I guess before I spent time blowing all that stuff off, I should have went ahead and drilled this hole first. We got to drill a 7/16 hole back through the pilot hole that we drilled here so that the bolt will fit. When you get ready to drill the other side, make sure you get the drill bit centered into the pilot hole. And now it's time to assemble this. We'll get this done and tight, and the hard part will be over. The rest of this rear seat installation is super easy. So this is what I bought. It's a 7/16, 20 thread, grade 8 bolt that is 2.5 inches long. I got 2 flat washers and a nut to go with it. So these are the parts I bought. I'm gonna set these right up here. These are the parts that come with the harness. And we're gonna use this nut, which coincidentally is larger than this one. Now keep that in mind because we're gonna put these on in a specific way and I will explain why. We're going to use this lock washer and the spacer and the bracket. So we'll set these up there as well. The bolt we're not using. Now it is time to assemble. So we'll take the bolt and the flat washer. That gives it much more surface area to tighten up against this square metal tubing. Put it through. You see it goes right through that plastic hole, or the hole we bored in the plastic, excuse me. I'll get it out in a second. Then we put the spacer in here. That goes up inside the plastic and also gives a nice solid surface to tighten up against the square tube. And then what we want is the larger of the two nuts. The reason is the hole in this is made for that shoulder bolt. I couldn't really drill and put a bolt this size through this tube. It would take away even more of the material. It would be huge. It would be harder to get it to fit. So we're going to use the larger nut here. That'll give a good surface area for this to tighten against. So bolt, flat washer, then the other side spacer. And then the larger nut that came with the harness. I'm just going to go ahead and run it all the way up. We're going to go ahead and tighten these and go ahead and torque this down as well. This is a 19 millimeter that fits the nut and a 5/8 that fits the bolt. Alright, get that snugged in there good, and then we're going to torque it down, mainly because you never really can get a good feel doing it by hand. You want to make sure it's tight enough without being too tight. So using these is a good way to prevent that. Next step, put on our bracket. May have to kind of work into that plastic up there, but that's good. That helps hold it in place for you. Then we put our flat washer, because of the size of the hole in the bracket, then the lock washer, make sure nothing tries to back out, and then this nut. Now on the other side, I was able to use a extension universal and get to that nut from the other side going this direction. But here, that's not going to be possible because of this tube. I'm not going to be able to take that tube off. So we're just going to give this one a good old hand tighten, even though I just recommended not doing that. Don't really have a choice here. All right, starting to get good and snug, so now we need to keep it straight. I'm going to stick my big screwdriver in this side. Look at it, get it leveled up bar, and hold it there while I tighten this nut the rest of the way up. And this is grade 8 hardware, so it is pretty tough. And it's still level. Alright, that's all I got. That is a good, secure connection. Now, obviously, it should go without saying that you need to occasionally check these and make sure they're still tight. Make sure the engine vibration and just general trail use didn't make them begin to work their way loose. And that goes for all the bolts and all these harnesses. The last thing you want is to have to depend on it and not having realized that one of these worked its way loose and it comes off when you need it most. And I'm going to go ahead and work this cover down into place. Now with these snorkels on here and these clamps that I refuse to take off because I want them right back in the same spot they were, this can be a bit of an exercise. But while I'm doing it, I wanted to mention there's been several Facebook posts lately of people being killed while off-roading in their vehicles of different makes and models, and each time the reason that they ended up dead was the same. They were not wearing their seat belts and or harnesses. So you guys wear your damn seat belts or your harnesses if you're able. You don't look cool when you don't wear them. You look a goddamn idiot. Nobody's gonna laugh at you for wearing a seat belt. And if they do, then they're the idiot. I'm gonna go ahead and take the boot off of this original thing. Seat belt buckle catch and release unit. Gonna go ahead and put this right side lap belt in. Just goes right back into the same bracket. Put the shoulder bolt on the spacer to keep the strap off the mounting plate. The lock washer. And the nut. Now we have a 3/4 socket here and 9/16 wrench to tighten this up. I got my torque wrench set back on the 40 pounds. So we'll just get that tightened up. And you do lose a couple with the universal and extension and all that, but it's negligible. If you feel that strongly about it, just add another 2, 3, 4 pounds to whatever you're tightening up. The lap belt for the other side is actually easier to get to going in this direction. All right, bolt through the bracket with the spacer through the original mounting hole, and then lock washer and the nut. And do be careful not to drop these down into the nether regions of your machine. You will have a hard time fishing that out. All right, now this time we're going to have 9/16 socket and 3/4 inch wrench. torque that down to the 40 pounds just like all the rest. Good secure connection and still free to pull as straight as possible. Now it's time to go ahead and get the shoulder straps in place. Before we put them down in there, we need to take this slide adjuster and get it off the belt in the direction it comes. We're gonna turn it around so it's facing, well, I mean the plate is the same, but we're gonna feed it through in the other direction so that when you're making your adjustments, you can do it from this side. And I will show you why when we get to that here in a minute. So when you're holding it, you're actually gonna come in from the back and then go down through the front here. We'll slide it up the belt. Don't let it get all twisted. Now, usually the way shoulder straps sit, and then they come through the seat, and then this is the way you want the slide adjuster facing towards you, so that the belt is coming out of the back and then going back through toward the back. Now to get it through there, just drop this down into the hole, and then you can just raise your panel up some, reach down here and feed it through the bracket. Grab it through here, pull it back out of the hole. Now to start the adjustment to getting it in place, as it's coming back up, you come right behind this strap and go through the bracket or the slide adjuster in the same way from the same direction. And then we go back over it, come through this side. That's just temporary. We'll have to adjust it once the seats are in, and then the occupant, when they see where they need these. Now this extra strap, because when it's finally, in your final adjustment, you roll it back over and go back through the bottom of this adjuster again, you can take the loose strap and just stuff it right back down there. And it tucks it away nicely. Now for now, we're just gonna leave it like that. Now we're gonna get the seat ready and stick it in here and then put all these harnesses together. Well, these seats are much easier to replace the bottom brackets with or on than the other ones, because these do not slide. Once they're in place, they don't come back off. So just remove these four bolts here. They're T27 Torx. Now the bracket is loose. Set it aside, set the seat aside, and we're done with it. Now we'll just put it right back on, put the same four screws back in the same four holes. Get all four of them in before you begin tightening things down. When you get to the last one, I'm going to go ahead and tighten it up. I'm going to put these in the same position they were before. Make sure you kind of keep the slots centered on these washers. And make sure your seat is not only straight, but supported well. And just like before, we're going to attach this seat release strap right here to the seat release using the extra washer like I did on the front. Put the washer on the little screw, put it through from the top, put it through the strap. Once they're both through, put both washers on there and the little nut, and then tighten it up. Like I mentioned with the other ones, there's no need in cranking down on these too hard. These are pretty sturdy straps and the holes are stitched. These are little nylock nuts, so they're not going to back off. Just snug them up good, and then we're ready to put the seat in. Actually, we are not quite ready to put the seat in. I got to put the center console back on first. It's going to be really hard to get the seat in, or get that in, when the seat is in. So, yeah. Just feed it up under there. Pull this strap through. Pull this strap through. Make sure it's untwisted. And then just like with the others, roll up the tip. Poke it up through the boot. And then as you hold it tight, hold the strap tight and lower the boot so that it will be, the strap will come out facing in the right direction. Then poke it down in the hole. Get the groove seated all around the plastic. And then when you buckle all this up again, you'll have a nice clean finish. I'm not worrying about this side because, as I mentioned, I have to take all this back apart. I'm not even going to put the screws in it, but at this time you would put your two push pins in here, your one T40 here, push pins on both sides here, and then these two on your front console. And the seat in place, now we just assemble our harnesses. Take this strap through the hole. Make sure you're not twisted. And then on this side, we put the piece with the buckle with the hole in it here, the latch with the hole, the piece of leather with the silica gel pack. I'm not going to even worry about taking that plastic off right now. You feed the belt between the roller and the rest of the lap belt. We'll go wrap it over, feed it back across. Pull it down. There, that one is set, and we'll feed the rest of the loose strap back through the hole and let it drop down below the seat. The same thing for this side. Through the hole, pull on it, make sure you're not twisted. Get it through the slide adjuster here. Cinch it up, poke it through the hole, stuff it down there. Below the seat, I'm not going to worry about getting that nice and neat at this point, but you can lay it down in there and get it below the seat. We'll go ahead and latch this, velcro that, and the bottom half is ready, and we'll just get the shoulder straps ready. Take your shoulder straps, feed them through the pass-through in the seat. And for starters, we'll want to adjust this so that you got 2, maybe 3 inches between the split right here and the pass-throughs. So we'll have to adjust this to get it about to that point. And the best way to do that is go ahead and pull your strap and release your seat a little bit. And then pull this top strap, the adjustment strap, out of the first loop. Leave it in the second loop though. Get this buckle pulled all the way up by the where the stitches are here to give you more room to work with. And then pull this strap up like that and then snap the seat in place. Now we'll pull the belts where we want them and then start taking up the slack. So now when I pull on these, see, that's as far as they'll go. Needed a little bit more of a gap here, so pull it down just a little more. All right, that looks good. Now what I'm gonna do is feed these back through. Release the seat again and just kind of hold it up here with my arm. Careful not to pull the strap through the slide adjuster. Just leave it right where it is and then go ahead and feed it back through the other half. If you have these pulled down, it'll make it easier. Now that's not going anywhere. Just after you make the second pass, just come back across again and go back through the bottom part of the adjuster so that your strap is in wrapped over the adjuster one more time. That's actually like three passes. And then take the rest of it and you poke it back down into your slot, your panel, to get rid of the excess. Make sure you get this out of the way. Snap your seat back in place. Once again, feed these back through. And if you didn't let it move, it should be right where you want it. So moving back around to the front, all we have to do is attach these shoulder straps through their slide adjusters. These are the not so friendly ones with the springs. A little more difficult. All right, that is seat and harness is installed, secure. Once you get situated down in there and get these buckled in, you are not going anywhere. One thing to keep be mindful of is you want these back top of these pads to be right up on your shoulders, but you want this sternum strap to be well below your neckline. So these are in there, the fronts are in there. I wish I could go ahead and put the other side back together and call it done, but I have a lot more work to do this machine, as I keep mentioning. So be on the lookout for more videos. I want to thank SuperATV for, again, the awesome products that they make for our toys. These are a great addition. They make the RZR look better. It's more comfortable, it's more supportive, and much safer. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next video.